Take a look, not exactly at that version of Highwayman, but I may get to that. That's kind of like on my next agenda. But this one, what we're going to look at in this lesson is Jimmy Webb's fabulous tune, Highwayman. And we're going to look at how Glen Campbell did it, which was really, I can't call it the original version, but really Jimmy did it on an album in 1977 called El Mirage. And then a couple years, and it needed a little work. Glenn did the work and did it a couple years later on his album called Highwayman, came out in 1979. And Glenn's version is very fast fingerpicking there. Now, he's not playing the melody like I was just doing there. And like, again, different lesson. And at the end of this, I'll probably sing through it so you can hear how it all works and stuff like that. You probably are more familiar with the song because of the Highwaymen, who did it a few years later, having, at the suggestion of Glen Campbell. And, oh, he played it for them, and the four of them were putting together this album. This is, of course, Willie Waylon and Chris and Johnny Cash. And it was the perfect song for them. The incarnation song about people that lived maybe 50 years apart. And each of those guys sang a different verse. Of course, the first verse being about a highwayman in the early 19th century, probably. The next one being about a sailor, probably in the later 19th century. The next one being about a dam builder, probably in the early 20th century. And then the late 20th century idea of a star flying across, flying a starship. So anyway, so those guys' version was different, but Glenn's had great guitar playing in it, and it falls into a category that I have called generic fingerpicking. It doesn't really matter what you do as long as you keep the whole thing rolling, keep the bass notes in there, and keep some patterns going. I have put together a tab of a bunch of examples of playing through a whole verse with a whole bunch of examples of what I might do if I was playing it. Now, I'm not going to play through the whole thing fast and like that exactly the way my tab is, but I'll walk you through the tab because it really is a lot of embellishments that you can throw into these chords. So the first thing we'll talk about is just some basic finger picking patterns. Four beat patterns where there are four bass notes, maybe alternating with three bass notes. Here I'm playing an A minor chord. The song's in the key of C minor, and we get there by putting a capo at the third fret and playing in A minor. So we've got easy chords, A minor, G, F. Glenn plays F major sevens in all of his spots. C and D minor, that's it. It's a five chord song. Until we get into the tag almost, where we hear this descending bass line. And this was a part that Glenn really added a lot to, because he added a lot to the meaning of the song by not just rambling on there, like Jimmy did a little bit, and making it very specific, you know, but I am still around. Oh, sing it in the right key. If I'm going to sing this, I'm going to do it down lower. Round and around and around and around. And later, I'll be back again and again and again. It really kind of drives home the point of coming back. Anyway, we might also take a look. I probably should mention this because I'm not 100% sure I'm going to do this, because I heard another version later, or as I was doing research into this, of Jimmy Webb doing this with Mark Knopfler. And you hear Knopfler's guitar playing. They do it a little bit differently with a capo at the first. And you hear, I'll show you a quick example of that. You hear Mark start off like this. Much slower. Anyway, I hope to add that chapter to the lesson later, especially if there's a little bit of interest in it. But that's not what we're dealing with today. So in this lesson, I'm going to talk about some different finger picking patterns very similar to other lessons that I have that I, again, where I, what I call generic fingerpicking. The lesson that was done recently on Please Come to Boston. Another good example. Just kind of, it doesn't really matter too much what you do while you're singing. It's just accompanying. And but in the case of this one, for example, here's what I have for the first first couple measures. Something like that, that is pretty elaborate for what you might do while you're singing, but it's just a bunch of little licks and exercises and embellishments that you could work into your playing of this any place you want. So that's what we're going to be doing in this lesson, is talking about the chord progression to Highwayman. We'll do it at the third fret, capoed in thinking in A minor, and I'll walk through the progression and some just basic fingerpicking patterns first, and the chords. The chords are all relatively easy. Part of the challenge with this song, if you watch some of Glenn's versions of it, especially ones where he's playing without an orchestra, is the guitar picking is very fast. So if you're not used to ripping along down here, this is going to cause its own challenge in just keeping it going very fast. And what I'd recommend for that is take a very simple pattern. Something like that, which I'll talk about that next, as a matter of fact. So, coming up, lesson on Jimmy Webb's Highwayman.